And we are back, baby. Again, a late night stream, so I gotta be a little bit quiet and whisper. I noticed on my last late night stream, late night horror game stream, my mic didn't really pick up my voice because I was whispering so much. Also, the game sound was very loud. I turned up the mic a little bit, so maybe that will help. But we're gonna play The Complex. It is marked as a horror game. Is it really a horror game? It's more like a. It is an FMV game, marked as horror. But we'll see. We'll see how it goes. Yeah. So jump in, have some fun. Sit back, relax, and enjoy. It's a guilty pleasure of mine, playing FMV games. I really like that. It's nice and relaxing. It's like watching a movie with choices, you know. It's fun. And I hope you find it fun as well to watch.
So I've done a full body cleanse on both of them. Space is sterile.
Did you get blood samples for Kensington's research project?
Mm-hmm.
Nice work, Dr. Wakefield.
So another drone?
Yeah. They dropped nerve agent on their apartment block. A woman was coming home from the shops. The boy was playing with a soccer ball.
What, you mean a football?
Hi, I'm Amy, your...
Talo.
Pleasure to meet you, Talo.
Are you gonna hurt me?
I'm Team Doctor. You got injured, but I'll have you back playing football very soon. Reese, I need to administer atropine.
Yeah, I didn't get a chance to restart the vials.
Supply tent now! It's okay. Tell him, it's okay. Atropine injections worked on everyone I treated in Syria. Okay? All right, all right. What's your name?
Dima.
Dima?
We're not safe here. The Supreme Leader ordered this attack.
We're here to help you.
He's trying to kill us. Both of us will stand against him. Oh, tell me. Will this kind of ruin my life? Doctor.
It's very serious. You're in the best possible hands, I promise.
Honesty. It's very nice to hear it for once. Thank you. I need to save my baby.
Sorry.
The supply tent's been depleted. There's only one vial left.
For two people? Oh no.
What are you gonna do?
Make a decision.
Dima? Talo. I don't fucking know. Dima. She got a baby. She's a woman.
Dima, give me your arm. Dima, please, you have to trust me. This will save you and your baby. Reese, how do I save them both? Reese! Stand on the precipice of history. I'm Dr. Amy Tennant, and I'm here on behalf of the visionary Natalie Kensington to inform you how your investments have made that possible. Firstly, we've been using your billions for the greater good.
Honesty, bravery, intelligence. Okay.
Kensington Corporation's relationship with Kindar has flourished since the resolution of its civil war. Our teams have been working on development projects with some of the country's top scientists. Natalie has even developed an internship program for some of the country's brightest young minds. In fact, some of our Kindarian interns are here with us today.
Boo-hwee! Is Kindar still a totalitarian state? Human rights violations and all that shit?
Kindar is at peace, but your concern is understandable. May I continue my presentation?
I'm just saying, it's bad PR for us to associate with Kensington if she's dealing with a dictator.
Well, as you've seen, that's simply not the case.
Why is there so much research happening out there? It's a fucking waste of our money and resources.
Kindar is a former British colony, and we're all here trying to help it recover. Seems like good philanthropic PR to me.
And it's a tax haven.
Go on.
How are we gonna play this? Are we gonna be like very kind and friendly, or shall we be like brutally honest and, you know, straight to the point, you know? I'm not gonna take a friendly approach, I think.
The Kensington Complex.
No.
Our impenetrable HQ of laboratories, built bespoke to Natalie's specifications by the world-renowned Parker Kaplani. Deep within the complex is Security Lab Alpha, a womb of scientific advancement. There, we have something remarkable in development. I'm sure all of your news feeds have told you that Gordon Grosvenor's expedition to Mars is becoming a reality. Yes, the first person to set foot on Mars will be British if we can hurdle this final obstacle together.
Hey. Hey. Are you okay?
Yeah, rough night. Don't do drugs, Kay.
We can't fit a hospital on a 10-ton Mars lander. How do we get around this? Nanocells. Stem cells interwoven with nanotech. Once inside a host, they migrate to the site of injury. There, they regrow bone and generate extra blood to help catalyze the healing process. Tiny magic bullets.
What's your problem?
This is, of course, just a mock-up. The real nanocells are still in development and securely back at the complex, but once they're ready, we can begin regulated human trials. Having treated victims of chemical attacks all over the world, I know that nanocells could be miracle tech.
Well, that's not good.
Amy, you need it urgently.
Hang on. I have some serious concerns about this.
Likewise. Before my employer invests any more capital, she wants some answers.
Amy, I really can't wait. We need to get you to the car now.
Yes, absolutely. What are your questions?
What's the catch of this miracle tech? You've made it in a lab, so is it radioactive or what?
What about privacy laws? Are they trackable?
Don't worry, we're talking about genetic reprogramming here, so nothing artificial or unnatural would ever go into our consumers' bodies.
Niente di naturale o artificiale, quindi non ce n'è bisogno.
Amy, please, we need you now. It's an emergency.
I have to go, but please stay and enjoy the wonderful hospitality. Let's go, Emily.
We need to get you on the scene immediately.
The scene? What happened?
It's already gone viral.
I'm ruling out food poisoning.
She has other alarming symptoms, we've been told. Naturally, everyone's crying terrorism.
A suicide bomber with a malfunctioning bioweapon?
We need to get her to the complex.
Okay, why is this our problem?
Because she's one of our interns.
Thank God you're here. This is beyond our remit.
Excellent quarantine work. I'll examine her back at the complex.
And we were waiting on your word before moving her. A single person drone or ground ambulance.
The drone will get her there faster.
But it's more dangerous. If it crashes, then whatever's inside her, it gets out into the public.
It won't crash. It's Kensington tech. Use the drone, Amy.
Drone, don't fuck it up. So, what else do we know about her?
Nothing yet. Let's get back to the complex.
Buddy's a renegade.
Well, the prospect of losing a friend in a strange country, I can empathise with that. Today we need all your field experience, Amy.
Time to roll back the years.
Mm-hmm. You can say that again.
You've got to be kidding me.
Nah.
It's been a while, Dr. Wakefield. You got here fast.
Well, there weren't any blood-vomiting ladies on my tube line. Reese Wakefield. Hug.
Let's walk and talk.
So, which legend fed the media the anthrax rumor?
I need to take this.
Was it her?
So, do we have a name yet?
Claire Mahek, she's one of us.
Inside job?
No, she must be acting alone. Why else would she take the tube?
Well, Uber doesn't offer a getaway car service yet, so... Look, if we consider the hysteria might actually be valid.
What, terrorism? I highly doubt it.
Perceptive as ever.
Hey, Amy, look. I promise I didn't know you still worked here. If I did, I would have...
Stayed away? Yeah, I'm sure.
Look.
Why are you skydiving? Or bungee jumping? Or whatever it is that you were up to?
Because I'm passing through London. I checked my Twitter feed this morning, saw something I could help with. Plus, Kensington wants my expertise again.
Well, she already has my expertise.
I'm not disputing that, nor am I apologising for the skydiving. Guy's got to live.
And if you could come back and let me know your decisions. Okay, thank you.
You didn't want to run this by me?
Two lifesavers are better than one.
Reese Wakefield is a deserter.
I know he's let us down in the past, but people change. Emily did due diligence too. Come on.
Hey, guys, can I just have 5 minutes? Just need to use the gents.
Can we go, please?
Ned, I'm gonna use the toilet as well.
There are toilets down there. Amy!
Well, he's tricky. I don't trust him. Let's follow him. Let's follow that fucker. He did use the toilet, huh?
Gender fluid toilets. New policy.
Gender fluid? Okay. Let's see what this fucker is up to. Don't trust that little bitch. Okay, maybe I jumped to a conclusion too quick. I guess. Okay. Well, he couldn't help it that there was only one syringe at the beginning of the game. It could only save one person. Not his fault. I don't know. Maybe he's stressed from that whole situation.
Yeah, is this my tech?
Nothing leaves or enters the lab without us knowing about it.
Emily and I will get to the bottom of that. You just get the nanocells, otherwise our life's work's gone.
All of the nanocells are inside of her?
It was a master batch. No duplicates were made. Good luck.
Oh my god, you guys are serious about your fashion.
Yeah, no more frumpy hazmat suits.
Pressure suits?
You'll see.
All right. Better changing facilities than in the Congo, eh?
Yeah. And Kindar.
We're going into space.
I have my mic on mute.
Vacuum conditions active.
I said, no, let's not sneak a peek. But that's you.
Echo!
This vacuum acts as the last line of defense to prevent microbes from escaping the lab. The lack of air makes it sterile as hell.
Well, that's great on a microscopic level, but it could do with some physical barriers. How long have you worked here again? It wasn't just skydiving. I needed a reset. Try new things.
So the meditation's new.
So's the spying.
Touché.
Vacuum conditions inactive.
Shit, I made a mess. Chips all over me. Okay. So they were kind of like friends, maybe, you know, there was a little spark in the beginning there, but now it's all over. Whole situation in the beginning.
Thing, Dr. Emily North. This is Dr. Reese.
They both handled it their own way.
Cool ponytail.
Let me take you to her.
Maybe it's not so bad after all. You know?
Feels like we're at the center of those dolls that go inside each other.
Matryoshka dolls.
Yeah. Russian, aren't they? So what's your story then, Malkin?
Wanted to assist Dr. Tennant since I saw a talk at the Plains Summit. About the extracellular matrix and lattice in stem cells.
Holy shit, it's attacking the bone structure.
We've never seen anything like it.
I have a sample of her blood under the microscope.
This is my tech. The nanocells are inside her. But they're unfinished. There's no off switch, so they're just coursing through her body, producing excess bone and blood.
But how could she have contracted them?
From a spillage, maybe.
They barely survive for 2 minutes once they're exposed to air, and she didn't have the authorization to access them. Someone's put them in her. No, leave it in, Claire. You need it.
Feels fucking weird.
You a terrorist?
It'd be a terrible one if I was. I did this for Mina. What's Mina?
Terrorist organization.
Oh, will you stop that, please?
Look, how many times have we seen a lone wolf release pathogens into the air?
Nanocells aren't airborne. They can only be transferred via blood-to-blood contact. Answer call.
Named as Claire Marhek, a Kendarian intern at Kendrick.
TV off. Tell me you can retrieve our nanocells.
Not directly. We'd need to extract a large blood sample to keep them active. From there, I'll use that as a roadmap to recreate the master batch.
Seems simple enough. She has plenty of blood to spare.
Not exactly. Her new bone matter is consuming her body's resources at an accelerated rate. If I remove that much blood in one go, she'll die.
And if she dies before you extract her blood?
Without a living host, the nanocells will just dissipate.
Au revoir, nanocells.
So either way she dies. Okay. Amy, we're gonna have to go for the option where we retain our asset.
Natalie, I can't just...
I'll get back to you. End call.
What should we do, Doctor?
Wow, don't make me do that decision, man. What the fuck?
Set up for a full blood diagnostic. There has to be a way to get the nanocells out of her safely.
That's brutal.
Dr. Wakefield, please replace her IV. I can't risk any outside contamination.
Sure thing.
Dr. Tennant.
Need to replace this, okay? Don't bite me. Whoa! Shit, sorry. Rusty, you know what I mean? And don't go anywhere.
He has that blood on his hands? What was that, man? Why did he do it like that? It's like, did he stab himself in the head?
Who delivered this crate?
Because it's like...
Well, it's in the way. It needs to be moved.
Yo, Reese. Get over here, bitch.
Reese. Dr. Wakefield. Can you move this crate, please?
Fucking assistant. Yeah, I'm working, man. Do us a favor. Still gotta deal with this.
I'm in the middle of this.
Cheers, fella.
Dr. North. Dr. North. Sorry, my shoulder's playing up. Do you mind?
The fuck?
Oh my god!
Dr. North?
Help me!
It's not personal.
God, help me!
We're gonna save you, okay?
I knew there was something off about Malkin. What kind of a scientist has a fucking ponytail?
You're fine.
Is Claire all right?
I'm currently the safest person in this room.
Good enough for me.
Why are we in lockdown mode?
It's detecting the poison from the acid bomb. It won't be in the air for much longer.
Thanks for that.
Call Natalie Kensington. Emily, where's Natalie? There's been an incident in the lab.
Yeah, I can see that, and the biosecurity's kicked in.
I need Natalie on the line right now. I don't care who she's with.
Yeah, okay, she's in her office. I'll call you right back. End call.
Okay. First things first, let's get this cleaned up. Okay, ready?
Mm-hmm. We'll be back in a minute, Claire. Don't go anywhere.
He's actually very funny.
Mistake, yep.
That needs to come out one way or another.
Kensington could have at least left us some of her expensive whiskey. This is gonna stink.
Fuck! Ah! Oh! Oh!
Oh! Cold.
Oh. Mm.
I have to clean this wound.
No, 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 it'll be fine. We've got bigger fish to fry.
Did you hear that?
Yeah, what was that?
Wait here, I'm gonna go see if there's something in the intensive lab.
No, Amy, it's fine. Look, we need to figure out what the fuck is going on.
Hang tight, Claire.
It's just like Yemen.
Don't mind me. No. That came from the void.
Is that?
It must be coming from beyond the walls.
Is there any security cameras we can check?
On the computer, but I don't know how. My assistant did that.
All right, would you mind? Thank you. Right, got it. These are the security cameras in the void.
In masks?
What's the rumbling, though? Sound doesn't travel in a vacuum.
Shit, they've deactivated the vacuum.
No prizes for guessing who the brains of this operation is.
God bless those security walls, eh?
This is impossible. They would need unprecedented access to our security systems to be doing this.
They heard them, cavalry. Look, they're Kandarian too. I knew you were part of something bigger.
Umpas all together because they have the same features. Big eyes and big lips too. The divisions in my country are complex. Those bunch are not from my team.
And now they're fucking with us. Answer call.
Amy, what's going on down there?
You've been infiltrated, Kensington. Dr. Malkin was a plant. Thanks to him, Dr. North is dead, and so are my dreams of becoming a professional footballer.
But you killed Malkin.
Yeah, how'd you know that?
Emily checked security footage from the lab.
I mean, does privacy even exist around here?
There are three masked intruders in the void, and they're armed.
They've deactivated the vacuum and bypassed the security wall.
I'm still alive. Make sure she knows that.
Biosecurity is still enabled, so you are safe no matter what.
Well, unless they open the door with that magic laptop.
I'll get on to this intruder situation.
Oh, well, not that I'm not grateful, but why is lockdown mode still active?
The poison from the acid bomb has dissipated and the bioprotector is containing Claire's infection.
It must be detecting something else. The safety of London is paramount. We can't risk a bug getting into the city. Amy, you need to extract Claire's blood, especially if the intruders have come for her. The nanocells cannot fall into the wrong hands.
Well, there's an easy way to prevent that.
We smoke Claire.
No!
End call. Wow. Still can't keep your cool under pressure.
She's responsible for this.
That makes no sense. We're her only hope at retrieving the nanocells.
Yeah, she's going to let us extract the nanocells and then kill us by gunfire.
Wow. Bleak much?
All right, look, Parker Kaplani designed this lab, right? Do you think he built an escape route, a back door, anything?
I don't know. We'd have to ask him ourselves.
Yoo-hoo.
What now, Claire?
Let me have a look. It's dead, dead, dead. Oh, shit. Three dead. Is that good? Oh, yeah, that was inevitable. Honesty, bravery, courage. Do I need to have a good relationship?
Remove the dead people.
Glad that she mentions it.
Yeah.
Okay. How about this one?
Enough with the Natalie theories.
Remember those new skills I was telling you about? Well, advanced computing is one of them. Programming, coding.
Hacking?
I prefer the term unsolicited browsing. Yeah, no, sorry. Hacking is better. Look, I know you two are besties, but I find Natalie a bit... Yeah. Let's access her camera. Give her a little listen.
This is how scientists get killed, you know. Where did you learn to do this?
If I told you, I'd have to kill you. Ready?
Wait, we shouldn't...
Look, if she's got nothing to hide, what's the issue? We're in this together. We need to cooperate if we're going to survive.
Okay, do it.
Go ahead.
The three intruders in the void have managed to lock every lift and door giving us access down there. Whatever they've done has caused electrical blips throughout the entire building. There are questions.
Have the security idiots announced an upgrade gone awry? No one can think this Claire situation's any more serious than it already is.
This seems planned, Natalie. There must be more traitors in our midst.
Emily, please! Two people are trapped in that lab with our prized asset.
They are our priority.
Announce the security upgrade.
Clear the airways in case she calls.
Who could the traitors be working for?
Let's ask the original.
Claire.
Amy.
What do you and your friends want?
I'm not an espionage mastermind. They aren't with me.
So how did all the nanocells end up inside you?
Isn't that totally obvious?
You should listen to Professor Xavier over there.
About what?
Kensington.
So she put them in you?
No. Not me. Thank you. Seriously.
How long have you been at the complex?
A year. We've always had passing conversations on higher floors, but I don't think you remember.
wanted to work in this lab with you.
Well, here we are. Claire, come on. Just tell me what's happening so that I can help you.
I got them all. Mina.
Who's Mina? Claire.
She's about as useful as a chocolate teapot. Ready for more cryptic bullshit?
Answer call.
Guys, you were right about the intruders. They've sabotaged the system
and have electronically barricaded themselves in the void.
Yeah. Tell us something we don't know, please.
How are they
bypassing your security system so easily?
Kensington Corporation stock plummets amidst links
to... Rescue plans are being made.
Well, have you contacted Parker Kaplani? He designed the lab. He'll know how to get us out of here.
We've been trying, but he could be anywhere on the planet right now. Parker has no compunctions about who he builds labs for, as long as he pays quote.
Excuse me.
Emily, wait. Please. Give us something. Help us.
Dr. Malkin, the three intruders in the void, Claire, they all infiltrated the complex expertly.
Another country in the space race, or...?
Possibly, but they might be trying to steal the nanocells, or destroy them. I'm going to move heaven and earth to try and get hold of Parker.
Thank you, Emily.
End call.
I think Emily's cool.
Whatever they're doing up there, we need to come up with some ideas of our own.
I think.
Is there anything else you can do in the computer system?
I can hack the communication lines, get in touch with Parker Kaplani myself.
Okay, awesome. You do that. I'm going to look for a way out of here. You okay?
Yeah. I think the air is getting stale down here.
No, that's impossible. Even in lockdown mode, there's always a steady supply of oxygen. Back, Sleeping Beauty. I need something to get me past that vent cover. I wished I was taller.
Amy, do you need a hand? See, even with one leg, Wakefield is still the MVP.
Most vanishing person?
Ooh.
Sorry, that was harsh.
No, you've grown some wit, I'm proud. Come on then. Be careful. So that's good. Yeah, okay, yeah.
Can you hold this back?
Yeah, I got it.
Reese, the vent continues behind the oxygen tank.
Can you squeeze past it?
Only one way to find out.
Okay.
man, if I said go for it, would have maybe ended badly.
Made it.
That's excellent news. I thought you were going to get stuck.
I think there's something further on.
Oh, it's quite cute, matching wounds. I mean, mine is slightly more impressive.
Mine put both of yours to shame.
I hate her. So, anything else of note up there?
Just a storeroom full of broken glass and... What's his deal?
There's only one wall left between them and the lab door.
Please tell me you got a hold of Parker.
Negative. I got a hold of the CCTV footage from the past 24 hours.
Okay. Sift through it, see if there's anything helpful.
Roger that. Fucking sneaky bastard.
Wait, Claire got access to the lab?
Is that your master batch?
How did she get that level of clearance on her ID card?
Wait, what were you? You injected yourself? Why didn't the lab shut down?
The nanocells need time to diffuse in the bloodstream.
I was able to get out of the complex before feeling the effects.
What the fuck is she doing in the storeroom?
I destroyed all the duplicate nanocells too.
What? I didn't authorize any duplicates to be made.
So you were just stealing the master batch for employers to replicate? Who? Who was it? Was it the Russians?
No, I was heading to MI6 to...
Oh, fucking impeccable timing as always.
MI6? Why were you taking them there, Claire?
Nensico!
Parker. We got a hold of Parker.
Half true. I was already en route. I get alerted every time shit hits the fan in one of my labs.
We also have the identities of the three intruders. Sending them through.
Oh.
These guys?
They're from last year's batch of Kindarian interns.
Sleepers, like Malkin.
Yeah. Guys, there's one security wall between them and us. What have you got?
What are our best options, Parker?
I need 10 more minutes to study these blueprints. That lab was built to contain world-altering alchemy. So excuse me if back doors weren't part of my thinking.
Amy?
End call.
Reese.
What? Do you want to listen to a fucking bullshit about nanocells again? We've got 10 minutes to think without all that shit.
Look, I didn't want to hang this over. It's not meant for you. You need to see the truth about Kensington and Kinder.
What is it?
Just watch.
Careful, Amy.
Always.
Wait.
Off.
The fuck is her? Oh my god.
Two files. Kensington and Picnic. Which one do you want to watch?
Kensington.
To the UN.
Kensington, Ma. What's the problem? We quashed uprising villages, and you got human trials to assess your technology. To burn one stone.
But three whole villages.
Your scientists need not know how the data was acquired. The Supreme Leader is a man of discretion. We trust you are the same.
Most certainly.
Make sure of it, or we will.
I think my mind's thinking the same thing as yours, so do you really want to watch the other video?
Claire, please.
Sure.
Look, look.
You've forgotten the wine, but remembered your phone. Typical.
Nina's mad at me these days.
Well, I'm sorry I forgot the wine, okay?
Yeah.
Raw onion bhajis, egg mayo, tomatoes.
Claire takes too many selfies in London.
Not that much. No, look, I'm showing the surroundings. Look, look. Look how pretty this grass is. Come on, let's take a picture. Look at the camera. Smile.
Understand now?
You see, the Kandarian government in Natalie Kensington experimented with your nanocells. On my people, my village, my parents, my sister Mina. They're all killed for opposing the dictatorship.
Natalie was making duplicates of the master badge behind my back. My tech killed people.
And you were taking all the evidence from MI6? In that USB and in your veins?
Now the Supreme Leader has activated a sleeper cell in the complex to cover his tracks.
Yeah, not to mention Natalie's. Why didn't you tell us this before?
I didn't trust you.
How's it going?
Reject call. Amy. We need to take a minute and think about this, okay?
I'm fine, I promise.
Hey, look. I know a rash decision when I see one.
Are you not going to expose Natalie? After what you've just seen?
We need to deal with our current predicament. Plus, I really need the toilet again. Would you believe this isn't the weirdest place I've taken a shit?
Do you need me to stay and help you?
No, you're fine, this bed.
I'll be sitting outside.
Okay.
Hey, we get out of here? Will you quit like you said?
Pass. I never thought I'd have to answer that question.
No, you do the right thing, you always do.
A habit I wish I had.
Well, it might have rubbed off on you if you'd stuck around. Why'd you leave me?
Well, look. Okay.
The absurdity? Not knowing whether
saving someone was the right thing to do if it condemned them to a life of pain?
It's too much for me.
Coward isn't the man for you anyway.
That wasn't your call to make. We were a team.
Hindsight's a bitch, eh? Heard of Mr. Cracking Fortnite in Eritrea?
Where can I sign up for this war-torn world tour you guys were on?
You've said enough, Claire.
Tenant, I am finished and decent. You may remove me from my throne.
Did she say enough, though? Was that maybe a bit too harsh?
They're going to shoot their way in.
Their bullets won't dent these doors. They were built to withstand much more than that. The Void's last resort defense mechanism is the kicker. When it detects a rogue pathogen, it generates a white heat flash to eliminate the threat.
He's sick.
She's hardwired in already. We are fucking fucked.
Anthony Hall. Guys, they're nearly inside, and we know why they're here.
Parker, what options have we got?
Enough! While Parker was accessing the lab security mainframe for bypasses, we saw records of who gained entry in the last 24 hours.
Claire entered using someone else's ID credentials.
Yours, Amy.
But that's impossible. My ID card is right here.
Amy didn't help me. I snuck into her office and I copied her credentials off the computer. You're the liar, Natalie.
You don't have a voice here, Claire.
But we know about Kindar.
Brees.
We have proof. Lots.
Nonsense.
Look, the intruders are Natalie and Kindar's way of making sure that we die with their dirty little secret.
We know that you hacked your own security, Natalie.
That's ridiculous.
Yeah, your cybersecurity sucks. Even Reese hacked in easily.
Reese has been hacking the system.
He isn't an employee here, is he? What's your story, buddy?
He spent the last few years bouncing between pharma companies around the world. A mercenary. Whose side are you on, Wakefield?
You know what? Fuck this.
Everyone, calm down. All I know is that if they get in, the nanocells are gone forever. Natalie, please.
We aren't the traitors. Help us, stall them, do anything.
Amelia, regardless of what we think of each other right now, you're one of my closest friends. Parker.
So we're trusting these guys now?
Yes, we are.
Can the Void jam electronics?
Negative.
Could you reinitialize the vacuum? Two of them aren't wearing helmets.
I can't. They've locked us out.
Reese could. His computer down there is hardwired into the system.
All right.
Okay, talk me through it as fast as you can.
Help, Amy! Help! Help!
What's going on, Claire?
Something wrong. My heart. I need to wear a mask.
I trust you.
Last time she spit in your face? Oh my god, I was stupid.
Turn the vacuum back on? Not so smug now, are you?
We're not out of the woods yet.
All right, they're still unlocking the door. One down, two to go.
Come on.
Suffocate, you bastards.
Kills them?
Call Natalie Kensington.
You're okay. Answer call.
We saw the lab door didn't open. Good work, Wakefield.
It was a close one, Parker.
Thanks for the lead, Natalie. There's still an armed intruder out there. Parker, what else do you have for us?
I could go for 90's internet, unplug the lab, plug it back in.
That would kill lockdown mode and the vacuum for 60 seconds. You guys can then escape before everything initializes.
Emily has a security team poised to handle the last intruder.
No, that's a shit plan. He's standing right outside the door. Security team of sprinters wouldn't make it down before he wastes us.
He's right, Parker.
It's a calculated risk worth taking.
Okay, well, when could you do this?
Whenever you're...
When you get Claire's blood.
The fuck, Natalie.
Yes, I know it will kill her, but she's gonna die anyway. She'd be sacrificing herself to save millions. Think, Amy. We can't start over again. This has been our lives for the past 4 years. We're not the only country trying for nanocells.
I'm not a murderer.
You're a monster, Kensington.
Just take the blood, Amy.
Time is running out. Deal or no deal?
End call.
In a corner here, Emmy.
There has to be another way that doesn't involve killing Claire.
There isn't. We're trapped.
Yeah, by Natalie. The lab's in lockdown mode because she ordered it. There's no other chemical threat outside of Claire's bioprotector.
Yeah, there is. Actually.
How?
Should have brushed up on my needle handling. Look, this is a Mexican standoff we're going to lose. It won't be long until I'm like Claire, and eventually the oxygen will run out, so Parker's crazy plan of opening that door is our only hope.
You've changed your tune. Maybe Natalie will rescue us.
Yeah, you want to bet? All the evidence of her actions in Kindar is down here. The nanocells are our only leverage. Take her blood, however much you need.
Claire, give me your arm, please.
I thought you were different.
Claire, your arm.
Can you honestly? Can you save me?
There's almost no chance of it. Your internal physiology is completely changed, and I can't predict what's gonna happen.
You're weak.
Look, I don't even know if I'm gonna survive this. But if I do, I promise.
Stop! I've got enough.
What the fuck are you talking about?
Don't stick it in. That's what she said.
Reese.
Just close the bioprotector. Claire can live to fight another day. It's about time I contributed an escape plan.
What?
While Parker was talking me through the vacuum reset, I realized that a full lab reset wouldn't be much different. We don't need those pricks upstairs.
But if you reset the lab, they'll be alerted.
That's where things get creative. I hacked into the lab security camera and recorded the last 3 minutes of you preparing to extract Claire's blood. I can output that 3 minutes of footage onto their security feed. While you escape, they'll think you're following orders.
How did you come up with this?
Sorry to move in.
Okay, but what about our last remaining obstacle outside? And why are you speaking in the second person?
I'm gonna take him out. I'm infected. As soon as I step into the void, that heat flash will trigger.
Reese, you've lost it.
If I die in here, lockdown mode ends and he gets in. If I die out there, so does he, and you have a chance. I've been the weak link. It's time to become an asset. Take Claire, run, and save her.
This is madness. There has to be a way for all of us to survive.
I'm the optimist.
That's what you always.
I didn't want to be the nice one. For once in a playthrough, be harsh, you know? Be harsh and cold, but I end up being nice anyway.
Please. Come on,
no, look, I chose this, okay? That's how you make a life. Every single choice along the way counts.
I fucking hate you.
You know, I went back to that beach in Kindar to face it. Was there. Dima. She's just playing with a little girl. She called her Amy. I'm sorry for leaving you. Get back. Didn't your mother ever tell you not to kiss anyone carrying a life-threatening pathogen? I appreciate the sentiment, though. More than you know.
Switch places with me, Reese.
this stage, you have a far better chance of surviving than I do. Come on. You have all of the evidence against Kensington. Make sure the world sees it.
No, Claire, I'll do it.
Drop it. The bioprotector will stop the lab detecting your infection, and you two can escape. Come on!
I promise we'll expose Natalie, and we'll share your story with the world.
Thank you. I can't beat the fuck out of this thing.
Oh, what the fuck? Yeah, this game needs another playthrough because I need to see the other choices. I want to see how it goes. Key of Void. Rhys getting sick. Well, he does stab himself, so. Then he puts his hand on his wound.
Did you do that, Parker?
No. I'm sitting here. Okay. Thank you.
Let's do this. Nailed it, Claire.
All looks good to me.
Yeah. She's going to get the nano cells. Well done, Amy.
I wouldn't have. What was that? Nothing.
Amy, fuck that. Get a machine gun.
yeah, get a machine gun. Fuck that gun. Get the big one.
All right, Kevin.
Okay, ready?
Mm-hmm.
We have to change out of our lab suits. They'll draw too much attention.
How bad is it? Can you see the bone?
I'm gonna go to the disabled toilet and grab the fold-up wheelchair, okay? Change quick.
Yes, ma'am. Almost look like a right sight.
I wasn't bluffing about the security team. Okay, there's an exit out of the back of the building. It'll be way less guarded.
Right, so what are we waiting for?
Natalie's office is down there.
Let's just get the fuck out of here.
Yeah, let's. Finish what Claire started.
MI6, here we come.
Stop right there, Amy Tennant.
Okay.
I guess 3 minutes wasn't long enough.
We know Wakefield has nanocells in his system. Hand him over and this can end without bloodshed.
Well, that's clearly bullshit.
Just do it, Amy.
What if I shoot him right now?
Then the nanocells are gone forever.
Steady. We need Reese alive.
Yeah. Reese wants to stay alive too. Amy?
This is a mistake, Amy.
You're bluffing, right?
Oh, come on, Amy. You're not really going to do this over a few Kandarians.
Joyce. See you now.
Hello. I'm Dame Natalie Kensington. Last year, Kensington Corporation garnered a Nobel Peace Prize for the advancement of medical technology. Our breakthrough nanocell treatment was crucial to Gordon Grosvenor's Mars landing and has revolutionized the treatment of war zone injuries. Today, our miracle tech becomes available to you and your family in all British hospitals. Global medical care begins here.
Holy shit, what an ending. Shit, man. I think I fucked up that ending. Let's Google how many endings there are. Nine endings in total. There are nine endings altogether. cadaver. So this is it. Honesty, bravery, curiosity, intelligence, sensitivity. Shit. Endings found 1 out of 9. Scenes discovered. Decisions made. Personality assessment. Neurotic. Neurotic? Personality status. Neurotic. That was pretty good. That was pretty good. We're gonna do another playthrough one of these days, and I'll record that as well. That as well. That was pretty fun. Good little FMV. I think the acting was really good. It was a really good story. Really good acting. I say that usually from all the FMVs I played, but this one had really, really good acting, and the storyline was really fun. Yeah, it was good. It was good. I enjoyed it. And I hope you did too. This is the end. I'm off to bed. Thank you all for watching. I'll catch you all on the next one. I'm out. Peace.